MI is an example of a coagulative necrosis, is what need to be remembered. Where do you find Sister Joseph's nodules periumbilical? So the question was, what is the method by which the metastasis occur in case of Sister Joseph's nodules? It is the transperitoneal spread is the one which you need to basically remember. Now coming to the blood transfusion, if you happen to give a massive blood transfusion, typically what will happen, doctor? Post transfusion, purpura will develop after doing the transfusion. What is the cause for the purpura? It is the antibodies which are developed against the platelets, not against bone marrow. Platelet specific alloantibodies are the ones which are responsible for the post transfusion purpura, is what you have to ultimately remember. It usually occurs 5 to 9 days after the transfusion, and how can you treat? You can block those antibody formation by giving high dose IV immunoglobulin, is what you need to remember. Now let's talk about propofol. Propofol, invariably one question comes on propofol, that is our deal. Typically in propofol, the recovery, if you compare, it is much faster compared to that of the thiopentone. Assertion is false. That is the reason we use the propofol in the daycare surgery. And propofol has got a shorter context sensitive half-life, is what you need to basically remember. So what is meant by context sensitive half-life is my question to all of you. So basically it is the time taken for the blood plasma concentration of a drug to decline to 1/2 after the infusion is being stopped, is called as context sensitive half-time. So that is typically shorter in the case of the propofol, is what need to be basically remembered. Is the clearing of the propofol, is it hepatic blood flow dependent or not, is another favorite question of the examiner. Clearance of the propofol from the plasma exceeds the hepatic blood flow, is very, very important. And do you need P450 system in order to metabolize the propofol? Yes, it is important for the removal of the drug from the plasma, is what need to be remembered. In fact, propofol metabolism is both hepatic and also extrahepatic dependent. Now, doctor, a person is working as a driver for a long time and he remembers how to drive without unconsciously he knows how to drive. So what type of memory do you call it as? Fundamentally, doctor, long-term memory is being divided into two subtypes. Explicit memory, which is also called declarative memory. Implicit memory, which is called as procedural memory, are the two kinds of memories. Declarative memory means what? Memory of the facts and events. Facts and events.